I'd like to turn the stand over to Dr. Bushhouse now, if I could, and he will explain a little bit about what the program is and how it's going to operate tonight.
Thank you, Jerry. 2 years ago, the staff came to me with a recommendation that we do something to recognize scholastic achievement. And part of the rationale was that every week we see pictures and articles in the newspapers of our athletes and their performance, and at the end of their season, we award them a varsity letter to put on their varsity jackets to give them recognition for their athletic abilities. And only at the end of each semester do we publish an honor roll listing the names of the students who have all A's or all A's and B's. And nowhere do we really recognize the academic achievement by our students. And they recommended to us that we start a program where we award a varsity letter for academics. And so last year was our first year of presenting a regular varsity letter with a lamp of knowledge for the team indication. And this year will be our second year where we have some returnees for their second recognition or their second award. We're very pleased to do this, and we want our young people to know that we recognize the academic achievement that they have put forth and to be proud of what they've done and also serve as a stimulus to maintain that academic performance. If you look at the back of your program tonight, we have listed all of the recipients, the individuals with an asterisk next to their name indicates that they are a second year recipient. They will receive a little gold colored bar to attach to the academic letter that they received last year, and hopefully by the time our program is in full operation and we've been able to go through all of our classes, a student not only will have the academic letter, but there will be three gold bars there as well. To qualify for the letter or the recognition, a student has to have all A's or all A's and B's both semesters of last year. Now we are not talking about the 9-week grades that come out that are just indicators of what's happening. The semester grade is the final grade that goes on the transcripts. And so all of the young people that are named here on the back of the program are those who maintained all A's and B's throughout all of last year. And we're really proud of them, and we're pleased that you can be here tonight to see these awards take place. I'd like to introduce now Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Fitzgerald, to make a few comments about our program tonight.
Thank you, Dr. Bushhouse. This is really a warm kind of a feeling to do this, have this kind of a program. We think all along that the academics will receive their own award or reward for what they do, but I guess for some of us, we can really be proud of the fact that the idea for this came from the teaching staff. Their concern and interest in the students that they work with doesn't always show in a way in which super recognition is given. So for one reason, I'm really proud to have that kind of a staff in our high school who take that time to adapt a program in which they recognize the students that they work with. The other thing that I think is really kind of important is that as students go through school, a lot of things happen to them that they take for granted, and they don't really realize the impact that it's going to have on their life. Academic excellence is really a basis for everything that you will do from this day forward, or from the time that you began to excel in your classwork. And the recognition being given to you tonight is a way of saying to you, great job, keep it up, don't let down on these kinds of things, because it's going to mean a lot more to you as you get older. Those of us who are older, some of us know that what that means, and we have no way of going back and starting over. The one thing I think that's important that I can say, when you go through and take as many classes and study under as many teachers as someone like Dr. Bushhouse or myself with graduate degrees and so on, every once in a while you have to look back and say, why am I doing this? How did I get here? I wish I had done more earlier. If there was one thing that was possible for you to take away from here as a young student, which you still are, and any of us would be grateful to be in your place, the one idea that I would ask you to take is that what you've done has been good. What you're capable of doing is great. You can continue with very minimum additional effort and stay at the level that you've achieved for this recognition tonight. It will become important. You will have as much fun and as much opportunity for extra things and time with colleagues and friends, even though you study. Most of you, as I look around and see the parents and recognize the students that I don't always get to see, but a lot of you I do, and the names that I recognize, I know that you're already active in a number of things. And it's a great compliment to you to know that you can do as much as you do and do it as well as you're doing it. Our hope is that you recognize that and that you continue on in that vein. You will never be sorry for the time that you spend improving what you can do and striving for something that's just a little bit more than what somebody else thought you might be able to do. I want to express my personal congratulations to you for being selected in this manner to be here tonight. I want to congratulate you on the efforts that you put forward. They are important. They will always be. And now from representing the Board of Education, the President of the Board of Education, Mr. Kevin Stugler.
Thank you, Dr. Bushhouse. It's always tough to get up and follow three great speakers, so I guess mine will be very short, which probably won't be offended at. I was, of course, here last year, and it's a real pleasure to be here again this year representing the Board of Education, and we certainly send our congratulations to all of you. It's nice to see so many of you returning again, and I hope to see many of you here again in the future. It's interesting to me that oftentimes someone thinks of an active achiever as someone who studies constantly, and I believe that's not true with this group. I happen to be reading the CHS here, the latest edition, which is probably the first for this year. I received it in my board agenda last Friday, and I've been reading that over the past couple of days. And you read the news articles, and you find many people listed on here are also in those articles for student government, school musical, whatever it might be. You'll find them listed in the newspaper as well. That indicates to me that they don't study all the time. They're still able to be academic achievers, participate in other things. All of the other extracurricular activities are, of course, as important as being an achiever, and they certainly will make you a well-rounded individual. On behalf of the Board of Education, we hope to see many of you back here again. We wish you well in your future and congratulate you on this achievement also. Thank you.
Before we start the presentations, I would like to just amplify, I guess, the desire to recognize academics. If you've read the newspaper that Mr. Skidler just mentioned, you'll find that the Twin Valley Athletic Association, which is the conference we participate in,
is also attempting to recognize academic performance, and this year they will be awarding certificates to those athletes who have maintained a 3.25 grade point average all the way through school and finished the season on the varsity team, so that we do have or will have in the Twin Valley an all-conference scholar-athlete award or scholar-athlete team in each sport. And we also will be naming in March the All-Twin Valley Academic Team, which will be made up of the top scholars of the 8-member schools. So we, as principals in the league, are also trying to promote excellence in education and academics. Anytime you plan an event like this, you're sure to conflict with something else. We pick Wednesday night because we have the fewest athletic events going on Wednesday nights. However, we had a tennis match tonight. I think some of them have made it from that situation to here. We have the musical rehearsal going on, and a number of our young people are down at the Tibbetts practicing right now rather than being here. We have a number of members of last year's graduating class off to college. So there may be some holes in the presentations tonight. However, if the student cannot attend tonight or is not here and there is a parent, a brother or a sister or someone from the family representing them, I'd ask that you come up to receive the award instead of your child, because I think it's significant that we make these presentations and award the recognition where it is due. Our committee has recommended that we change our procedure a little bit this year rather than having each student troop up the full length of the auditorium to make the receive their award. We're going to ask, first of all, that all of the sophomores of the class of 90 that are listed to receive the award, if they would all come to the platform at this time and stand back in this area until we call their name. Then we will have them come out, receive the award, and everyone can see who the person is that goes with the name. All right? So if the members of the class of 90 would come to the stage.
Burl Martin. Daniel Martinen. Elizabeth Morgan. Andrew Scorfar. Stacy Sealscott. Andrew Scholl. Angela Sperry. Aaron Sprague. Aaron Siever. We have Jill Swan, Joy Thayer, Kevin Tobolsky, Katina Sebadal. Those are our recipients for the sophomore class as freshmen. While you're sitting there, just if you're waiting for your turn to come up or if you've been up here, each of the recipients of the award should have received a little yellow ticket tonight. If you would take just a moment or sometime while you're sitting there before the end of the program to write your name on the back of the ticket, and we will collect those near the end of the program. Make sure that you write it in good, legible handwriting so we won't have to pass them back. Okay? Members of the class of 89, please come to the stage. Bushhouse is at musical practice. I know where she is. Heather Whiteworth. Yun Sing Chan. Leanna Klaus. Second year award to Jason Coyle. To Scott Davis. Dustin Dean. Here we got one. Brian Feller. Stacy Force. Marsha Fuller. Christy Hecker. Beth Heller, Jenny Lockwood, Dawn Marriott, Autumn Marson, David Martinson, Gretchen Repka, Sonia Smith, Nikki Starr, Cheryl Stevens, Jill Strausser, she's probably out running 5 miles, Janet Weir, Michelle Wharton, and Aaron Zabani. Class of 89. Notice as we go along, the list gets shorter as well. I think the
subject must be a little more demanding for some of these young people. First of all, Patrick Engel, Bradley Bettinger, Bryce Bettinger, Christy Beitler, Stephen Demlow, Ann Garthway, Brent Kraholski, Tara Hatfield, Kelly Langley, Paul Miller, Todd Miller, Kathy Mayer, Amy Moore, Mark Nichols, Tammy Reynolds, Jason Rubley, LaShawn Valley, Nick Westgate, Scott Wu, Kara Zila. Did you win tonight, Kara? No. He's in the bass. Class of 88. If you would come to the stage, you are here or their representatives. I know Walter's here, so Walter's going to come up. There we go. First of all, we have Walter Ward. Walter, congratulations. I think we have Margie Marat's mother. Okay. Are there any other representatives here tonight of last year's seniors? Okay. We will be mailing the awards to those young people who graduated last year. Did every one of the recipients that's here tonight receive one of the yellow tickets? Is there anyone who didn't get a ticket? There's, we have one that didn't get a ticket. There comes Mr. Scorpard. Mr. Martinson's going to come around with a little basket and collect your tickets if you have your name on. So there'll be a short pause here. Incentives for students to participate in school, follow the rules, almost a reward system. We have one business in town that is committed for the last 4 years to providing a varsity jacket to one of our students for some special kind of recognition. Tonight, we are going to hold a drawing, and the recipient is going to receive a gift certificate to T-shirt Alley for the towards the purchase of a Cardinal varsity jacket. And Judy Howe has done this, as I've said, for 4 years, supplied a varsity jacket for free. Last year was our first time at this meeting to make that drawing. Also, just to try to recognize some of the parents or give some recognition, over on our refreshment table, you'll see two arrangements of silk flowers that the committee went out and purchased for this evening. We're going to also draw the names of the students for each of these flower arrangements to provide to their parents. Unfortunately, the greens on the sage have to go back to walk their floors, okay? As soon as Mr. Markinson finishes collecting the tickets, we will hold our drawing. You don't have one? You have a ticket to turn in? Need a ticket? Mr. Scarfar?
Got a ticket.
Got to make sure everyone's in the drawing, except Dr. Fitzgerald. Committee members, their families, relatives, or who isn't, they seem to drawings. Our employees of the school. Please take your time to avail yourself of our refreshments.